Last round in Orlando was an epic beginning to World Finals 21. Inclement weather wreaked havoc on the track as the professor kicked off the 30th anniversary celebration with a maximum moment. And as the rain continued to pour at Camping World Stadium, a new star was born when the West Series champion dominated the field and became the best in the world. This round, we continue to make history as we crown three more champions. This is World Finals. This is round 26. This is Monster Jam.
The beginning of the World Finals of Monster Trucks. We are ready to go.
Oh, my. Unbelievable.
Lindsey Reed and Scooby-Doo and the cartwheel save.
Look at that!
Wow! Then he's got to walk the plank backflip!
Nice!
Welcome back to Camping World Stadium for round 26 of the 2022 Monster Jam season, where tonight we close out the season with three World Finals championships on the line. Hello, everyone. I'm Scott Jordan with Colt Stevens. And Colt, first, let's talk about last round, one of the wildest racing competitions we've ever seen. And when it was all said and done, Brandon Vinson is your Spin Master Racing World Champion.
Only thing I can say, it was epic. You know, I didn't know if they were going to run that last race, but I'm so glad they went green. It ended up being one of the best races I've ever seen. It was crazy slick, but it was awesome.
Let's take a look at the event breakdown for round 26. Three competitions here in Orlando. Eight drivers will compete in the Great Clips Two-Wheel Skills Challenge. Eight more will compete in the Lucas Oil High Jump Competition. And then the 24 drivers in the main field will compete in BKT Freestyle. And right now it's a much drier track than before. So what can we expect to see this round from the drivers?
You know, I got to give it to Dirt Crew. They absolutely turned this track around. It looks great out there. Nice faces, lots of jumps. I think we're going to see a lot of huge air. Nice moves. I mean, we've got a lot going on. I'm excited.
It's time right now for track talk, and earlier Colt and Leslie had a chance to visit the 3D model of the freestyle track, so take a look.
Drivers arrived early today to see the track being constructed. We had some bad weather, and so they're a little bit behind out there. It's not fully finished, but what do you notice up there from talking to drivers and seeing the track for yourself, Colt?
There's a lot going on this track out here, but you know what? We've seen a lot of these obstacles before. It's just gonna be a little bit bigger and steeper, which is gonna be more exciting. One thing I also noticed, there's four opportunities for a backflip on one of those container-style backflips, so I'm excited to see that. And I heard that they've actually been okay to do two consecutive backflips, so I'm excited about that.
That'll be very interesting. One thing I noticed and the drivers were talking about is that the only recovery area they have is right here, that these jumps are actually very tight. This jump will be gone after the high jump competition. And so what about recovering and trip hazards?
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of opportunity for a bad break, like a trip hazard out here on this track because there's so many pods, as you can see. But I like that as well. If you can get the timing and the technicality right, you can really get this truck set up, hit the brakes, downside, continue on. I love those technical moves, and I think we're gonna see a lot of that here today.
Let's go ahead and take a look at the driver lineup here for BKT Freestyle. A lot of heavy hitters who have been to the top of the mountain before. Adam Anderson in there, Ryan Anderson, Todd LeDuc, Tom Mentz, Cynthia Gauthier, always a factor. So a lot of formidable superstars here competing for the BKT World Finals Freestyle Championship. And with that, let's go down to the track for the beginning World Finals. Making his first World Finals appearance, Jamie Garner in Overboard.
Nice downside with the rear tires right there.
An average score on the season, 7.198.
He's gonna have to back up. Oh man, already.
Now deep on the red side of the track, Overboard gonna come off the side, ends up going into center lane. Another wheelie, he's getting these wheelie combos here, up over the stack and the bus.
Ooh, sky wheelie.
Just running out of room. It's the second time again. Clears the pod. Great landing for Jamie. He's soft on these landings, getting the front end up, getting these wheelie combos.
Over rotates, doesn't quite get to where he wants to go. Uh-oh, Scott, this could be bad for him.
Oh, he's going over again.
Oh, man, he gets the save. Can he save it?
Yes.
He does.
Jamie Carter gets a save.
Time to let her eat now, buddy. Go.
Body shredding like crazy.
Got the wow factor.
Goes deep by the backflip ram. Now comes back across the red side.
Got to be careful. We got body parts coming off this truck. Tech officials will shut him off, and they do.
36 seconds left, so a dynamite save for Jamie Garner. Take a look at the super glue. Glue to the action replay.
There you can see it kind of comes off. Lands hard on the left side. Sends him back over to the right. Luckily, he's able to get two BKTs to grab. Ends up with an awesome save.
So an 8.445 from the fans, 6.500 from the judges, and that 7.473 gives Jamie Garner the lead so far in BKT Freestyle. Charlie Pocken now up in Monster Mutt, the 2010 World Finals Freestyle Champion. He's got three Stadium Series championships under his belt as well in his 15th World Finals appearance.
Tries to go into a stop. He put a technical move in on this freestyle early.
Now, Charlie competed on a very competitive freestyle series. Stadium Yellow had four freestyle wins on the year, an average score of 8.487, which is incredibly tough in that field when he had Ryan Anderson, Tyler Menega, Camden Murphy, and Barton Musauer.
Right, you notice how Charlie coming off that ski jump kind of let off the throttle and then powered off the end. That's to keep the nose of that truck up. You have to power off a big ramp like that so that the truck does not nose over in the air.
And Charlie's in a great spot here as he comes off the FMX ramp, that step up smooth on the landing. And he's going right to the backflip ramp. So a great combo choice there. Goes from the step up to the backflip and nails it.
Did you see him roll in nice and smooth? Great transition, great control on that backflip.
A lot of time left on the clock, a minute to go. And he's got another technical move, gets a nose wheelie across the pod.
I mean, Charlie's really been throwing some technical moves down. He's a testament. You can teach an old dog new tricks. You know, oh my gosh!
Right on that circle spot, he's gonna save it!
Yeah! All right, is there any damage? It doesn't look like I was worried about a foiling bar, but it looks like everything's okay.
We got a backflip, we got a great save, we got some technical moves, what else?
Old school, my man!
Reverse from Charlie Pocken now over
cool.
The blue pod.
That is something that we would have seen back in the old days, back when my dad was driving and Dennis. Old school move.
Now goes over the bus, smooth on the landing again, back over that center pod, that center piece of dirt.
He's in first gear, Scott. I think he might have some transmission issues. That thing is really singing. He's got to be careful. Easy to get a transmission fire. Whenever you're such high RPMs, that transmission is getting mad hot.
And time has expired. What a run from Charlie Pocken. Take a look at the super glue glued to the action replay.
Right there, you can see it lands on kind of that weird mound they have out there. It catches a bad rebound, but it works out great for Chucky. But watch this move right here. This is so smooth. Set this up great. Downside just rolls in nice and consistent. Hammers that backflip. Great execution. Absolutely perfect.
9.061 from the fans. Judges 7.625. Holy cow, that is a big difference. Total score of 8.343. First place currently for Chucky Pocken. Up next, John Gordon and Bad Company out of Hiram, Georgia, running that brand new bright orange Bad Company body. John Gordon making his first World Finals appearance, two freestyle wins this season on Stadium Championship Series Red.
Oh, could have threw a little skills move in there.
John heads on over now, clears the car stack and the bus. Great landing.
I got to tell you, Scott, that's one of the worst landings right there. Actually, whenever that front end hits and it slams you back, it'll give you where your head goes forward and then slams back into the seat. We always call that the Tweety Bird move right there.
Well, he made it look good. Style points.
Yeah.
Now just demolishing the dirt on the blue pod. Comes down on the nose, going a little slow here across the center.
He's setting something up, maybe. Something might be hurting a truck.
No, he's going straight for the backflip.
Nice and easy. Oh, a huge backflip.
Man, he is not done yet. Gets a little bit rough there. Runs out of room.
Oh, it looks like Austin Powers.
Austin Powers move, and he clips the pot.
Stuck in a hole.
We were going the same place there. Austin Power parking job for John Gordon. Stuck between the backflip ramps. He comes out. 18 seconds to go.
Oh, man. We haven't seen this yet. A car. Like, it looks like the 8-back backflip, but it's out of a car. Look at that.
Oh, he's got a wheelie.
Oh, man. Epic.
Wow. Hey, a backflip, the Austin Powers job. A backflip onto the car and then a wheelie.
He's out of time.
And he parks it. What a run for John Gordon and Bad Company. Take a look at the super glue. Glue to the action replay.
Right here. Watch his backflip. This is huge. Really high. Comes down, lands just right. But this one off the car. So one thing about that car right there is John might be the last one to have an opportunity to hit that, because that car crushed in after he hit it right into a wheelie.
8.598 from the fans. Judges 7.750. A total score of 8.174. Been a fantastic start to the competition. Our three professional judges, Lindsey Reed, Scott Douglas, and Dennis Anderson, all have their work cut out for themselves. More BKT Freestyle, the Great Clip Skills Challenge, and the Lucas Oil High Jump Competition are all coming up next on Monster Jam. Welcome back to Monster Jam World Finals 21 as we continue with the BKT Freestyle Competition. Up next, it is Bari Moussaoui in Zombie. Hometown show for him, friends and family in the house. And Leslie, I know you chatted with Bari earlier today. What did he have to say?
His approach to the track is very interesting. He's not focusing on what he wants to hit, because he said there's way too many jumps out there that you can hit in the time that you have. So what he's focusing on is what not to hit. It's going to help him eliminate ramps faster and hit the things that he needs to get the points from the fans.
Thank you, Leslie.
I think that is an awesome strategy.
Bari had 6 freestyle wins on the season, making his 8th World Finals appearance. He won the first ever showdown back in 2012. His best freestyle finish was in 2018. He finished in 7th place.
Very patient right there. He's seeing the truck kind of getting all over the place. Bari was nice and patient.
And he's going to square up right to this backflip ramp on the red side. Sky Zombie and lands it.
Absolutely perfect.
Textbook backflip. He's going to make a right turn here and come back across the red side.
Got a little wild there. I was worried he's gonna catch a bad bounce and end up on his roof.
And now Bari turning back to the left, turning in. Is he gonna do another backflip? He is squaring up here to the blue side backflip ramp.
Hard on the rear again, so that's his second landing on that rear. Hopefully he can hold together.
Well, maybe he's got one left here. Now he's going all the way back across the track to the red side.
Launch that thing to the moon.
Zombie hits the ski jump, and he clears it by about 4 truck lengths. And that is going to end the run for Bari Moussaoui. So 2 beautiful backflips as we take a look at the super glue glued to the action replay.
Watch how Bari really is patient in this backflip right here. The first one lands perfectly and sets up for the second one. Comes down a little bit hard on the rear, but it hangs on. He's able to continue to have a great freestyle.
So Bari Moussaoui scored from the fans 8.367, from the judges 7.500, for a total of 7.934. Next up at BKT Freestyle, Caleb Blood, Soldier Fortune up from Stadium Championship Series Yellow.
She's gonna start right here, right out of the gate with some huge air. Coming up short though. We saw that earlier this week in qualifying as well, and I'm hoping that it doesn't show any gremlins from her coming up short over that big over-under.
Goes right over the bus stack, now coming back over to the red side of the track. Second time off the ski jump, clears it by a truck length, little bicycle on the landing.
Kind of a cool bounce there to the downside, that little bump they have on the other side.
She's slowing down a little bit, trying to line up here for the backflip. She is going to go for it. And she is going to land it. So a great backflip.
Perfect execution.
Second time off the ski jump. Tires keep moving. No brake check necessary.
Ooh, truck gets a little wild on the landing there.
Under 30 seconds to go. Back over the blue with Pod.
Oh, going for a whip. Can she save it? She's got it.
Got to hit reverse here. She does. Backs all the way up. And now she's going to go for another backflip. Number two here for Kayla Blood.
Same spot. Almost. Bent four-link bar, Scott.
And the run is over. Kayla Blood with two backflips. Take a look at the super glue. Glue to the action replay.
Little crooked coming in for the backflip. You can see she comes up short. Bends a four-link bar there. Costs a run early.
And scores are in. Fans scoring 7.868. Judges scoring 6.583 for a total of 7.226 for Kayla Blood. A lot of pressure in World Finals, especially in BKT Freestyle. And not everybody was able to make it to the top of the leaderboard. So let's take a look at some of our lower performing trucks. Cody Saucier in Dragon with a backflip and a save, but it was not enough to get a top score. Weston Anderson in Gravedigger failed at his backflip attempt. Motor issues plagued Kraken. Radamahan in Whiplash rolled with 15 seconds left on the clock. Gravedigger's Brandon Vincent didn't get a score at all. He crashed on the first hit. And Bryce Kenny and Great Clips Mohawk Warrior rolled over with a lot of time on the clock. Let's now take a look at our current BKT Freestyle leaderboard. Charlie Pocket is in first place with an 8.343. In second place is John Gordon in Bad Company. In third, Zombies Bart and Musauer. Holding the fourth spot is Jamie Garter in Overboard. And rounding out the top five, Cody Saucier in Dragon. Earlier today in Orlando, it was the Great Clips Two Wheel Skills Challenge. And Camden Murphy would finish in eighth place in Bakugan. Dragonoid trying for a popper. Gets stuck on the eight pack. Gets a reverse popper. Some nice air, but just gets caught up on that obstacle. In seventh place, it was Brandon Vincent trying to get a backflip going on the backflip ramp. Nothing there. Todd LeDuc in Blue Thunder would finish in sixth. He gets a long slinky bicycle, but not enough to wow the fans. In fifth place, it was El Toro Loco's Armando Castro with a nice popper on the far side of the track. He would get a moonwalk back up onto the ramp and end up in the top five in this competition. Coming in fourth place, Tristan England in Earthshaker. Slow and steady on the moonwalk on the center pod. He'd go right across and gets it right up into a reverse wheelie position, right on the lip, and then finishing on the podium in third. Ryan Anderson, son of a digger, gets a great bicycle into a cyclone. Look at the save. He would go right on the sidewalls into another cyclone, and he finishes in third and second. Tyler Menega in Gravedigger gets a nice save, ends up crab walking into a stoppie, gets the moonwalk right over the aid pack, ends up with another save, lands it right on the wheelie bar, keeps Gravedigger up on the pod for a second place finish and lands the save. And let's take a look at the winning run from Tom Mintz in Max D. Comes off right into a stoppie, slow, steady, edges out into a nose wheelie.
So much control.
This is the move that won him the World Championship in 2019. Now going back, here's the moonwalk back towards the container.
Oh, he's going for the backflip, and he's going to land
it. He got it.
Over rotates, but he's got the save.
He's got it. That was epic.
Tom Mintz gets the backflip on two wheels, lands the save. Take a look at the super glue glued to the action replay.
Goes right in from a maximum moonwalk, hits it perfectly, gets it to rotate, almost goes over forward, puts it in first real quick, and saves it. Great job.
So as the celebration continues with our top three drivers on the podium, the Great Clips Two Wheel Skills Challenge, let's take a final look at our leaderboard in this competition. Tom gets that win with a 9.336, Tyler Menega second, Ryan Anderson third, Tristan England in fourth, Armando Castro in fifth, Todd LeDuc sixth, Brandon Vincent in seventh, and Camden Murphy in eighth. The Lucas Oil High Jump competition also took place earlier today. And in this competition, eight of the sports elite had an opportunity for their highest jump across this great track at Camping World Stadium. Now, the measuring tool was the bottom of the lowest tire to the track. So let's take a look back at all of our competitors in the Lucas Oil High Jump. Coming in eighth place, Kristen Anderson in Gravedigger. She would get off to a great start. She had the Guinness World Record coming into here on the highest ramp jump, not getting it done in Orlando. And then Todd LeDuc in Blue Thunder attempted the LeDuc leap, but he gets caught on the side and ends up on the hood of Blue Thunder. Jim Kohler in Avenger would finish in sixth. Mr. Excitement going way above the track, landing on the back end of the truck. And then finishing in the top five, Cynthia Gauthier, the defending champion in Lucas Stabilizer. She would go high, but unfortunately falling short of a second world championship. Corey Rummel in Megalodon, he would finish in fourth. Mr. Extreme Air with a brake check. Gets the back end of that truck right down on the back and landing hard, but does not finish in the top three. Speaking of top three zombies, Bari Moussaour at the time would get that world record right there, ends up on the nose, save zombie, and he would finish on the podium. In second place, Tom Meents in Max D goes way up high over Orlando, Florida, gets a nice brake check, sticks to landing, and he would finish in second. And Ryan Anderson, son of a digger, powered by Hoonigan, ends up with his third world championship. Take a look.
Oh, almost wheelie!
Ryan Anderson, big jump there, and he gets it down on the four tires. Take a look at the Super Glue to the action replay.
Right here, comes out of the truck, almost wheelies coming out of the hole. Brake checks early, look at that. That just shows you, man, you do the technicalities correct and you could come away with a win.
A lot of great freestyle runs have already taken place. More still on the way as we continue with BKT Freestyle here in Orlando. Not only is World Finals the biggest event of the year, it is also home to the largest pit party, and there is plenty to do from the RC World Finals to freestyle motocross. It's an opportunity for the entire family to see the largest fleet of Monster Jam trucks on display and to meet all the drivers, including the icon Dennis Anderson. Now joining the pit party this year is Walmart with their brand new wellness integration, and El Toro Loco driver Elvis Linus got to check that out. Such a fun time for the entire family at the World Finals pit party. Now let's continue with the action. Up next in BKT Freestyle from Stadium Championship Series Red, Mark List, El Toro Loco.
Going right into his skills move, I love it. He didn't get to do skills, but Mark is known for having great skills as well.
Now he is just pushing that thing, the smoke coming out of the nose, gets it back down on all four BKTs. Now he's ramping it up. Two freestyle wins on the season for Mark List, 8.407 his average score.
Gets a little bicycle there too.
Four event championships.
One thing about Mark is he's not afraid to roll the dice. He's kind of a checkers or wreckers kind of driver.
And we saw Mark get off to a great start on Stadium Championship Series Red, winning the first two event championships.
Man, but they're really messing that APAC up. Almost gets high-centered.
But then, Cole, after that hot start, he battled truck issues all season long.
Yeah, he had electrical gremlins, but luckily he's got his original chassis back now. It's been repaired, so hopefully they don't show their face. Huge backflip, lands hard in the rear into a moonwalk. One wheel.
Nice combo move. Mark List goes from the backflip to the nose wheelie to the moonwalk.
Look at him, great control. Coming off a backflip into that. Can he walk it all the way up the step up? Can he, Scott?
He better try.
He's
if he
trying.
Wants to win this thing.
Oh, he can't do it. So close.
To go up that high on a step up ramp, what does that do to the transmission of the motor?
It doesn't change this. A moonwalk in general hurts the transmission just because of reverse. Reverse is not a very strong gear in a transmission.
Well, he's going right back at it to the backflip. And that's a huge one, bigger than the first one. Hard on the left wheel.
Yeah, Tyrod.
Yeah, he is done as we take a look at the Super Glue Glue to the action replay.
Right here goes into the backflip. Lands hard on the rear, but able to get a moonwalk out of it. One wheel even. This is what was cool to me. He almost got this truck to moonwalk all the way up the freestyle ramp or the backside of the step up.
The scores for El Toro Loco are in. The fans give it an 8.974. The judges 7.166. That is a total of 8.070. And that is third place for Mark List. Up next in BKT Freestyle, Cole Bernard and Black Pearl. But right now, Leslie is with the current BKT Freestyle leader, Chucky Pockin. Leslie.
So, not your typical approach to the track tonight, Charlie, but you still are on top with that score. How were you able to make that work without getting your methodical walk-in?
I didn't get my walk-in. You know, it's very frustrating for me not to go out there, engage everything, at least get ideas out there. I mean, from where I was sitting and watching things from back here, you've only got so much to work with, so much to understand what's going on out there. So I was really frustrated going out there, and I thought, you know what? That's right. This is the World Finals. We're going to wing this thing. We're going to throw it out there and throw it out hard, and hopefully we come out on top dog.
Charlie Pockin holds the lead in freestyle. He is currently the top dog here in this competition. Comes right back around, likes that jump, clears it this time. Nice bounce. Then over the dirt circle. It's called the dirt pond over there. That's what it looks like. And he's going for the backflip ramp. Kovenard hits
nice.
The backflip, squares it up.
Perfect backflip. Is he going to go right into another one? No, he's backing out.
We haven't seen the back-to-back yet, so I'd like to see somebody pull that off. Make his way now to the blue side of the track. Goes from the jam to the center pod of the blue pod. And now he is going to the blue backflip ramp. So he goes from one side of the track to the other. And he's got a second one successful.
Ah, oh, misses reverse. Went for a moonwalk, but misses reverse on that one.
11 seconds left. Now going to go over the bus stack. Clears it. Little off to the left of the pod.
Oh, this is a different angle right here. Is it going to work for him?
Crossing it up over the step up, and he's got the save.
Nice.
What a save.
One wheel save.
I think that might be the save of the night so far for Cole Denard. Nice pop there at the end. Take a look at the super glue. Glue to the action replay.
First backflip attempt right here. Great execution. Comes down just right. Right here. This is where it gets crazy. Goes kind of sideways on the step up, but it works out to Cole's advantage. Able to save that truck.
The scores for Black Pearl, fans scoring 8.684, judges scoring 7.250 for a total of 7.967. Now next in BKT Freestyle, two-time World Finals champion Todd the Duke in Blue Thunder. And for more on Todd, let's check back in with Leslie.
Guys, everybody knows that Todd LeDuc has a top five hit list when it comes to freestyle. And one of those five is the wow factor. He took a lot of time to talk to Charlie Pockin after his run to determine it and not to let anything out of the bag. He told me that he's got two options for his wow factor to try to win this.
All right, thank you, Leslie. He's going to need a wow factor. Todd LeDuc's been pretty quiet all weekend long here for both round 25 and now round 26. He's making his ninth World Finals appearance. He won it all in 2014 in freestyle and 2015 in racing. But the last couple World Finals he's had, Cole, he finished in second in 2018 and fourth in 2019. So Todd is a big play guy under pressure at World Finals.
Oh, now, no doubt Todd is one to watch when it comes to World Finals. He's known for throwing it down 100% at these events. There's some big air.
He's starting to let the truck eat a little bit. You're hearing that throttle rhythm just catch up, get loud as the RPMs arise. And now he is shut off here. He's got it refired, so he is facing the backflip ramp. Wonder if he was going to go for it there. He's got to make a move now to the far side of the track. Up over the jammer. Now he's going to face another backflip ramp. Goes up to the container, and he sends it, and he's got it on the back two tires. He's
got
a save, though. Todd LeDuc. Backflip into a save, 35 seconds left.
You know, Todd's known for that LeDuc leap, that big air at World Finals. Where is it at? Has he got something up his sleeve?
Nice air now right over the pod.
Oh, that was cool.
What a great way to clear that pod, and he's cross-threading now over the jammer.
Did you see it rebound to the top of that pod? That was so cool.
Running out of time if he's going to do something else. Bicycle
off the step up. He's driving
this
sucker.
And he's going way over, and he's got another save.
There's a wow factor for you.
And that is the end of the run for Todd LeDuc, so he ends it on a dynamite save. Take a look at the super glue. Blue to the action replay.
Goes into a backflip, under rotates, catches a bounce, but he's able to get a great save out of it. This one right here. Now watch this. This is control chaos. Absolutely going crazy across his floor, spinning around, does a bear roll, able to get it back to its tires.
Scores in for Todd LeDuc, fan scoring 8.545, judges 7.416 for a total of 7.981.
Oh, he is not a happy camper.
Next up with BKT Freestyle out of Oskaloosa, Iowa, the only four-time Triple Threat Series champion in Monster Jam history, it's Tyler Menninga in Gravedigger. And Tyler's done really well in racing throughout his career in World Finals, as this is his fourth appearance, but freestyle, not so much. His best finish was 15th back in 2019. On the season, Tyler Menninga across arenas and stadiums, 15 total freestyle wins with an average of 9.075. He finished second on Stadium Championship Series Yellow. Chucky Pockin remains your freestyle leader with a very manageable, very beatable score of 8.343. We haven't seen any driver yet, Cole, come anywhere close to a 9.
No, it's been a crazy freestyle session so far. All right, throwing some skills in.
Right to the top of the pod, gets a stoppie right into a moonwalk. Five turns Gravedigger over to the right, onto the jammer.
I really love the speed and momentum out of Tyler right now.
Back around now, coming over the far side of the track. Takes a lane right over the jammer again. So we like that jump, and now he's got the backflip ramp right in front of him. Hits the container. Just right into a moonwalk, wow. A one-wheel moonwalk.
Into a wheelie.
What a combo.
Backflip, moonwalk, wheelie.
You don't see that every day.
Oh, no. Got an electrical issue or something going on inside this truck. All right, he's got it refired.
He's got it, but 24 seconds left. He loses all momentum, now backs up. It's a throttle, clears the pod, gets a wheelie on the backside, up on the front two BKT tires, and across the jammer.
Give me something.
Ski jump into center lane, gets a bicycle.
Truck shuts off again.
He is done. So Tyler Menninga, electrical issues throughout the run, still able to get that incredible backflip moonwalk combo. Take a look at the super glue to the action replay.
Right here, lots of speed, momentum. Checks up, setting up for a backflip. Spins around, lands hard on the right rear, but he uses the rebound to his advantage, going into a moonwalk, then a wheelie. Awesome job by Tyler Menninga.
Scores for Tyler Menninga, fan judging 7.992, professional judges 7.583, for a total score of 7.788. It has been an amazing afternoon with action-packed BKT Freestyle so far. And with such an intense competition here at World Finals, not every driver can crack the top of that leaderboard. So let's take a look right now at some of the lower performing scores. Tristan Englund and Earthshaker broke early, left 90 seconds on the clock in his run. Kristen Anderson and Gravedigger filled the clock, but she had a hurt motor. Jim Kohler and Avenger lost a wheel. Adam Anderson and Gravedigger rolled on the car backflip attempt. Cynthia Gauthier and Lucas Stabilizer would roll on a save attempt. Corey Rubble and Megalodon didn't get a score. He broke with 92 seconds left on the clock. And Camden Murphy, Bakugan Dragonoid, attempted the backflip, but would roll the truck over. Now let's take a look at our current BKT Freestyle leaderboard. Charlie Pawkin has the score to beat right now, 8.343. In second place is John Gordon in Bad Company. In third, Mark List, El Toro Loco. In fourth, Todd LeDuc in Blue Thunder. And currently in fifth, Colvinard in the Black Pearl. And up next, the now 13-time World Finals champion, Tom Meents and Max D.
Out of the box, Scott. Huge air.
This season, Tom won his second Stadium Series, finishing first on Stadium Championship Series Red. It is his 20th World Finals appearance, 13 World Championships, including earlier in the Great Clips Two Wheel Skills Challenge, going back to back.
Another transfer, different jump.
He won the Freestyle Championship for the first time back in 2001, back-to-back in 02, then again in 04 and 06, and the last time he won Freestyle back in 2013. The two trucks remain. Chucky Pawkin is going to get a medal and make it to the podium no matter what happens with Max D or Son of a Digger, and Tom goes hard on the front. He gets a nose wheelie stoppie into a moonwalk. Great combo move, great catch by Tom Meents.
Using every bit of that reverse gear on that one.
Got a backflip ramp in his sights. He's heading straight forward on the blue side of the track. Sends Max D sky and big air.
Huge.
Comes down great. Oh, almost right into the wall,
nice!
But he saved it.
Now that's how you turn a truck around.
That's a cartwheel. I can't do that in real life. He just hit in a monster truck. Unreal. Trying to get his 14th world championship here, pulling out all the stops. He won the Great Clips Two Wheel Skills Challenge earlier, made it to the podium in a Lucas Oil high jump competition. And now another backflip coming up. Maximum air for Tom Meents, and he lands this one as well.
I think he hit that in first gear, Scott. That thing was really high in the RPMs. And a donut, we haven't seen a donut yet.
He's got a cyclone.
Oh yeah, that transmission is slipping bad.
Tom Meents, great run, powerful donut to close it out. Take a look at the super glue to the action replay.
right here. This is my favorite part. Comes in. You think he's going to need to hit reverse? Nope, he spins it right around one tire. No problem. And here's the backflip. Huge, high backflip. And then finishes it off with a maximum cyclone. Absolutely getting after it in that truck. Great freestyle from beginning to end.
Scores are in for Tom Meents. Fan score for Max D, 9.063. Judges score, 8.166. Total, 8.615. We have a new leader in BKT Freestyle, Tom Meents in Max D. So Chucky Parker now drops a second. And Cole Tom with a shot here, a legitimate shot at his 14th World Championship and his second of the day here in Orlando. Our final competitors, three-time World Finals champion Ryan Anderson instead of a digger. And earlier, Leslie Beers caught up with Ryan in this UNOH pit report.
When you talk about where you want to run in freestyle, nobody wants to go last, but here you are. You seem completely unaffected by it, and so you've been watching, you've been learning. You know, what are you thinking here, getting ready to get in your truck?
Going last definitely has an effect on scores, no doubt about it, because everybody's seen almost everything, and I'll have to go out there and work a lot harder to get even the equal score. But at the same time, everybody knows we try to save something special for last, so maybe I got a little reserve in the tank, but at the same time, I don't even need to talk about that because I'm not worried about it. I gotta not worry about it. I know I want to win a world championship, especially a freestyle one, but my main goal right now is gotta make sure that each and every one of these fans is on their feet having a good time, because whatever I do in this crazy son of a digger truck is the most insane thing they've seen all night. So I gotta make that my goal. I got to get that in my head and keep it there.
Ryan Anderson had the highest freestyle average in the sport this year.
Wins. Might clear the whole thing.
9.158 was his score. It is his ninth World Finals appearance. He's got three championships. He won the Lucas Oil high jump competition earlier this round. He wins this freestyle championship. He was match his dad, Dennis Anderson, with four world titles.
Going for a backflip early.
Very early with 78 seconds left.
Hard in the rear. Oh man. I thought he got an input shaft or something. He's good to go. Now go.
Ryan won freestyle at Sam Boyd Stadium back in 2018. And he now goes with a whip. Nose wheelie to end the pod run there, and then right over the jammer with a wheelie.
Oh, we got smoke coming from the motor. Hopefully it'll last.
Goes off to the side. Ryan loves throwing that truck into chaos mode, hitting jumps at different angles, cross-threading digger style.
Making me nervous, Ryan. Getting all crazy. Don't want to roll over in a corner like that. Eight-pack, we haven't seen this one yet. He's got it.
Nicely done. Gets the eight-pack into a wheelie. 17 seconds to go, clipping the container.
There it is. Come on, buddy, time to send it now.
Big air side slap into a bicycle.
Oh, he's got a locked up planter. Rear end's gone. Rear end is gone. A front wheel drive only.
Well, he is still throwing it. Everything
care.
He's got, Colt.
He's gonna run it into the ground, buddy.
Man, he is now done, finally. Oh man, what a run to close out BKT Freestyle. Take a look at the super glue to the action replay.
First backflip here. Lands hard in the rear end. Luckily the truck handles it, no problem. But I think it bent the rear housing, and that might be what cost him at the end of freestyle. Then right here, absolutely huge air. Rear end finally locks up. Nothing left in the rear of that truck, and he's just digging, trying to get that front end to pull him across his track.
The scores are in for son of a digger. Fan scoring 8.527, judges 8.066, for a total of 8.297. Ryan Anderson will finish third in BKT Freestyle. That means Tom Meents does it again, winning his 14th World Finals Championship. And he is down on the podium with the trophy and Leslie Mears. Leslie.
So Tom, the biggest thing we saw was that it was hard to find momentum. How were you able to find the momentum and the wow moments out there?
I just drove with my heart, number one. I knew if I could put down a good run, it would have Ryan thinking. He's an awesome competitor. He's always tough to beat. All these drivers are fantastic. But you know what? This was my weekend. Sorry, Dennis. I appreciate your 40 years of service, But man, I've had a great time at your Salvation Party!
The top three drivers now on the podium as we take a look at our final BKT overall leaderboard. The 9.063 from the fans, the 8.186 from the judges, and the total score of 8.615 gets it done for Tom Meents, winning the freestyle championship. Chucky Pocket and Monster Mutt will finish in second. Ryan Anderson and Son of a Digger will finish third in BKT Freestyle. So Tom Meents winning his 13th and 14th World Final Championships. Kind of ironic on the 40th anniversary of Gravedigger that Dennis Anderson's biggest rival reigned supreme at World Finals.
Yeah, it's crazy, but it makes for a great story. And one thing about it, that's why Tom Meents is a professor.
The Encore 40 years in the making right here, right now, as we celebrate the 40th anniversary of the legendary, iconic Gravedigger. Adam Anderson now looks like he's prepared to jump all five Gravedigger trucks that are lined up. He goes all the way back to the containers. And here comes Adam Anderson. He hits the ski jump, he goes skying, and he clears it. Unbelievable, all five Gravedigger trucks cleared with ease. Take a look at the super glue glued to the action replay.
That was impressive, not only the jump, but getting that truck slowed down. Truck soaked that up perfectly.
Fireworks going off here at Camping World Stadium. Thank you so much for joining us on the action-packed road to World Finals. For Colt Stevens and Leslie Mears, I'm Scott Jordan. Good night from Orlando, and we'll see you next season on Monster Jam.